Hello and welcome to another episode of my Facts and Glitches series, where I showcase some more of what I've learned about GTA 5 in over 7,100 hours of speedrunning experience and from my awesome viewers. It is possible to get a persistent death effect on your game. Simply find a wall that you can face while looking north and bring out an RPG. Save your game, then load back into the game while attempting to fire. Note, it is important for the wall to be north because your character will always face north when you load in if you are on foot. It sort of makes the game look like you're playing GTA 4, and the effect will persist until you die again. On the large tow trucks, the hitbox for the handle is a little bit too big, allowing you to get in from above. As many of you likely know, there is an effect unique to street races known as slipstreams, where sitting behind another racer produces white lines that give you a speed boost. What you likely don't know is that if you start a new game while in a street race, this effect will carry over to your new playthrough. So any mission where you chase a vehicle, it will produce a slipstream. The first mission where you can see this effect is Father Son, when you get close to the truck pulling Michael's boat. While throughout the speedrun, this effect would save a lot of time, it is not allowed in current rules.
Whoa, crap! You on the wrong boat, boy!
Here on the map, for some reason, there is a random piece of coral far away from the ocean. It is unlikely to be intentional, because if you save and reload, it will often disappear. So it turns out that any scripted train in the game can be destroyed. So at the end of the Paleto Score, there is a train, and therefore you can destroy it. Another fact on the Paleto Score is that if you drive the bulldozer in a particular way, the enemies won't spawn to harass Franklin.
You okay?
I ain't dead yet! I'm on my way!
As I'm sure most of you know, after you complete the first assassination mission, Franklin gets a new home. However, this does not occur until after you receive Lester's phone call, so it is possible to get inside Franklin's old home before the call can initiate.
Hey, it's done.
I know, good work.
Alright, well shit, let me know about the next thing.
And we needed someone to live there for tax purposes, so some guys are moving your stuff in.
Oh shit!
It's yours. Enjoy it. 3671 Wispy Mound Drive.
Obviously, those guys are very good at their job. Now that Franklin is in here, he is locked in, unless of course he dies or you switch character.
Can you please be normal today, Auntie?
With the right movement and a bit of luck, you can activate some vending machines without facing them.
Damn, that was alright.
Traditionally, at the end of missions, you are locked into slow movement and are thus unable to jump or run. But it was recently discovered that if spacebar isn't your primary or secondary jump button, you can jump during a mission pass screen. Before you ask, no, I have no idea why this works.
Okay? Goodbye, friend.
Hello.
Hey, dude, what's up?
Hey, good luck.
On the mission complications, you sneak into Michael's house as Franklin.
It's just because you have a massive gaper, bitch.
When you reach the garage, of course, you're meant to take the car, but you can actually run outside if you desire. What's funny is that the garage will continue to open for you as if you own the home. In the waterway at this location, there are some unusual stairs. By normal means, these are inaccessible, presumably they are just meant for decoration. Using mods to gain access, you can see that there is the illusion that you can walk up them to the surface, but actually these stairs have no collision. As for where these stairs would lead, they would lead to a parking lot. After friends reunited, the current version of the game automatically starts Fame or Shame if you switch to Michael. He is meant to be inaccessible in free roam at this point. However, if you specifically kill Michael and leave the mission, you will gain access to him in free roam. This is strange because other forms of mission fail would simply result in your being Trevor again when you exit the mission, leaving Michael still inaccessible. You can then bring Trevor and Michael together quite easily before they've officially reunited in the story. Not only will they not acknowledge their association, they seem to not want to be hostile with each other at all. When playing as Franklin in third person, his hands do not move when you use his special ability. At the bar where you can play darts, if you get the cops and then lose them while still being in the general area, it will create a funny glitch.
You know, I'm trying to help people, help the community, just doing the right thing, you know?
Oh, please.
That is the
same crap, different day.
Officers report attempting resisting arrest at the Yellow Jack Bar.
You mad?
At the beach, you will find this awning, which has very, very broken collision. Phones in this game are strong enough to block a bullet. Just because a surface has gaps doesn't mean cops can necessarily see through them, as shown by these poles here in the subway.
Give me cover!
It isn't the case that these gaps actually have solid material in them, but we simply can't see it, as cops can fire through them. When you first gain access to Franklin, Michael, and Trevor, you can go to an ATM to check what they've spent their money on. Of interest is that each character has spent money on things that we ourselves cannot do. People at this location will die to one touch.
Diet sodas are actually worse for you.
You want to die today?
You think twice!
Oh, you're my bitch now!
Oh my god!
Oddly though, it's only NPCs on the second floor.
Hey, sorry.
So that's it everyone, thank you for watching. If you like the video, I'd appreciate if you press like, and if you want to enter into my 200 USD giveaway, the link is down below. I hope you're all doing well.